does owning really nice makeup brushes have to cost you a whole week's worth of salary? Let's hope not, friends. We're gonna get into finding some really great alternatives to some beautiful makeup brushes and finding some dupes that might help you out and save you a few dollars. Let's get into affordable makeup brushes right now. Hello, my friends. I have about 8, maybe 10 to 10 makeup brushes that I want to talk about today. Several of them are dupes. At least 7 of them are dupes. And then I have a few others that I'd like to show you towards the end. And then there are a few of my tried and true brushes that I absolutely love that I do feel like, even though they are more expensive, that they're worth it. And I will show you that towards the end of the video. So if you're new to my channel, welcome to you. I'm glad that you're here, and I hope that you do decide to subscribe. And of course, all of you that have been with me for a long time, thank you so much for being a part of my life and my YouTube channel and sharing with me a bit of your day. Let's get into this video right now. So I want you to know that the brushes that I do have that I'm duping out, I think are fabulous brushes, and they're very, very great quality brushes as well. I am so tongue-tied today. Let's hope I can get through this video. The first one I'm gonna show you is from IT Cosmetics, and this is an IT brush for Ulta. I found this brush such a long time ago, and I will have a hard time finding names on these, so I'll make sure that I throw them up on the screen for you. This is the All Over Powder Brush. Big daddy powder brush. I mean, look how big it is. It's super soft, super, super fluffy, but this comes with a high price tag. But I did find one that is almost an exact dupe of it. It might be a tiny bit smaller, but this one from e.l.f. Cosmetics is such a good brush. Every bit is soft, every bit is durable. As a matter of fact, I think this is a little bit softer because it's not quite as dense as the IT one is. And I like that about a powder brush because it doesn't deposit as much. You can really go in and buff it, and it's a little bit softer. So I do like having a little bit fluffier than this one from IT. So this one from e.l.f. Cosmetics, I think, is a fantastic powder brush. And yeah, definitely dupes it out. Now, my other favorite brush of all time that I recently acquired last year is from BK Beauty. This is a fabulous, fabulous brush for doing your foundation because it's angled, it's very dense, so you don't use a lot of product because it doesn't go down in the brush itself, and you just stipple it all over, and it just is so good about the way that it distributes. I love this brush, but I happened across this one from e.l.f. as well, and it is almost identical, and you're gonna be able to see how it's cut. Now with these two, hi Ollie again, he's over there playing. With these two, you're gonna find that the e.l.f. one is not quite as dense as the one from BK Beauty. So you're gonna get just a little bit more product down in there, but the price difference is pretty significant. Now, I am not gonna say don't get this BK Beauty one because I love this brush. I love actually all of BK Beauty's brushes. I did purchase all of them around the holiday time. They had a little bit off, and I did just take the plunge and get them all. Fantastic quality. However, I do feel that e.l.f. has a great quality too. I have washed this thing like crazy. I have used this thing like crazy. It is identically shaped to it, and like I said, just a little bit more along the lines of being fluffier, a little bit softer. They perform the same though. And so if you can't really afford this one, even though I think these are great investment because they are such good quality, I think that this is a great dupe for it. Another one from BK Beauty that I think is a fantastic brush is this buffing powder brush right here. It is a very kind of a squatty powder brush, so it's more dense, and I use this more along the lines for doing my powder foundation when I do it, my mineral makeup, and I buff it, and I love this for that. You don't get too much on, you don't get real cakey because you're able to buff that in a little bit better. But I was at Target the other day, and I'm like, oh my gosh, that looks just like the brush that I have of BK Beauty's, and that is this Sonia Kashuk powder brush. These are such a absolute dead on dupe as far as that goes. Now, again, this one from BK Beauty is a little bit more dense. This one from Sonia Kashuk is just a tiny bit softer. I don't mind that though. And I think they're both just such good quality brushes. Sonia Kashuk has great quality as far as being able to wash them and how good they are about not losing hairs. I've never had any from Sonia Kashuk ever like lose any hairs on them. I just love her quality. So this is a really good dupe for this one, and this is great for mineral makeup, or if you're somebody that really likes to buff in your powder at the end, you could use this for liquid makeup too. You don't have to just use that angled one that I was showing earlier. Liquid makeup would be fine with this. It would put on a little bit lighter coatings than you had if you were using that other angled one. Sorry about my stutter today. I'm just having a day. Okay, this one right here is from Reefer. Reefer sent me a lot of their brushes, and I love their eye brushes. And this one is the 03, and it's a pencil brush. But what's nice about it is it's not so stiff that it doesn't smudge, you know, it smudges really well. So it has enough stiffness, but not too much, if that makes sense. So I really like this one for smudging out my under eyes. I think it's fantastic. But Morphe has this one is, I think, this one is an E36. And this one does almost identically the same. It's not quite as thin. I don't know if you can see that. Hopefully you'll be able to see it, but it's not quite as thin as the Reefer brush. But it does exactly the same thing when you're using it on your eyes. It's a pencil brush that is a little bit giving, and that's what I like about it. So I don't feel like I'm like scraping my eye as I'm doing lining and getting my eye more red or whatever. So I love that you can get this one for a fraction of the cost of the Reefer. Reefers are great brushes, but they are super expensive. I have two others that are really good dupes for Reefer brushes as well. This one is their 02. This is a flat, like pack it on type brush. So it's flat, but it's a little bit more dense than just a paddle brush. Excuse my shaking. I am not nervous. I do have a disability. And if I don't say that, I usually get somebody asking me if I'm okay. I have a palsy in my hands that is my disability, but I don't stop because of it. So that is what's going on with this brush right there. It's a flat shader brush, little bit domed. Love this brush for packing on my lid or going out there in the outer V and really packing on some shadow out there. And then after that, you can go in and, you know, buff it out with a bigger brush. But this is great for packing any color on your eyes. Now, Zoeva actually has the dupe. The reason that I put Zoeva as the dupe is because the brush is identical, but it's so much less expensive. So this is the dupe, same thing. It's a flat shader brush that's a little bit more thick than it is normally for a paddle brush. These two brushes, they could not be more identical if they tried. It is the exact same brush. This one lays down that product and just works so well. They are just as dense as each other. They're really, really great brushes, both of them. But this one from Zoeva is a fraction of the cost of the Reefer brush. I love both of these for the exact same reason, but price-wise, you can't beat it. And durability of Zoeva is just as good as Reefer brushes. Okay, Reefer and Wayne Goss make one of my very favorite brushes that is the same brush, but they're so, so expensive. So it's the Reefer 01 and the Wayne Goss 18. And I absolutely adore both of these brushes for laying down my transition color and then just going across and blending everything together so that your makeup is seamless. They're so close to each other. And again, the price tag is quite high, but these are excellent brushes as far as quality, never losing any, you know, bristles at all. They're very soft on the eyes. They're great. I absolutely love these two brushes. But again, we're talking that price tag that makes you want to choke at times. So I'm going to give you three alternatives to those two brushes. So Wayne Goss number 18, Reefer number 01, and then I have a Zoeva brush, and I love this Zoeva brush for how fluffy it is. It feels identical to these two brushes right here. This one from Zoeva, of course, because I'm blind as a bat, I can't see. Okay, this one is the 227 Luxe Soft Definer. So much like these two other brushes. I mean, really the way they perform is so close. And then the Luxie 231 is right here. And then the Morphe is the least expensive of all of them, and that is the M433. They are so close. All of them are just, they do the same thing. They act the same way. I just feel like these five brushes, I grab for one of them every single time I'm going to be doing my transition color. And they do the same thing. I don't feel like one outperforms the other. I was going to say which one is the best of all of them. I would probably have to say that I love the Zoeva one. I really, really do love it. And I think that if you're gonna, you know, dupe out these two, that Zoeva one is the identical one. But these two will save you a little bit of money from Luxie and Morphe. Love those. The last one that I have to talk about is the new one from e.l.f. that is the double-sided complexion brush. You have a buffer on this side for foundation, and then you have a buffer on this side for concealer. This one is an identical dupe to the It brush that is their complexion brush. I don't have that one right now because I gave it to my daughter, but that brush is super durable, and it's great for having both that you can just do your complexion products with and just buff those out, and it be right there, handy dandy. And that's what I loved about the It one as well. I think that this brush is probably a little bit softer than that one. I love this. I think it's so, so good. And I have had that It brush forever, but my daughter fell in love with it and I had to give it to her. So I'll make sure that I throw it up on the screen so you can see what I'm talking about. Maybe I should move this way a little bit. They are really, really close to each other. And this one is so good and a fraction of the cost too. And then I want to really quickly show you some affordable brushes that I think are just outstanding workhorse brushes. And I'm not going to tell you a lot about them because I have talked about most of them before. The e.l.f. small stipple brush. This one does so many different things. Nose contour, if you want it to do your under eye makeup, any sort of contour you want to do, fantastic brush. This is a fan brush that I've shown a million times on my channel. And this one, they don't make anymore, but there is one just like it on Amazon that is just so good. I think it's like $7. I've linked that before. This is one that is probably the newest one to me. This is a fan brush from BH Cosmetics. Now, I think that this might be going to go out of or discontinued because it's really cheap. And I use this for my contour. I use this for so many things. It's just a gorgeous brush, very soft, very luxurious feeling. I love BH's brushes anyway. And then Absolute Beauty sent me these two, and this one is supposed to be a bronzer brush. And I love the handle on the bottom of here. It's kind of got this like little indent right here. That little tapered part goes right against my finger right there, and it just seems to lay so nicely in my hand. And then I don't get too much pressure. I don't know if that's my imagination or what, but this is a beautiful brush for bronzer. Let me say that again. This is a beautiful brush for bronzer or blush or whatever you decide to use it for, powder, whatever. And then this one is their new little highlighter brush. They have a whole entire line of these, and they are good brushes. They're a good quality brush, and they really buff out well. And then before we go, I'm going to show you two brushes that are my ultimate favorites that I have not been able to find dupes for, and I'm asking you guys if you've ever seen a dupe for them. I never have. You see me use this brush all the time in tutorials, and this is another It brush for Ulta, and it is a super fluffy duo fiber powder brush. I love this brush because it doesn't matter how much I put onto my brush. You know, you can really swirl your brush in the powder. I guess you can get too much, but it's really easy to use, and I don't feel like I get too much powder on me ever. And it just goes over my face with one swipe, and I love that about it. This is uber soft. I felt like this was an investment, yes, but this has been my favorite powder brush for I can't tell you how long. I love this thing. It just puts powder down on the face so beautifully, and it's light and it's airy, and I really loved that I invested in this. And this is one that I got like probably 8 years ago. I love this thing. And then I also bought about that same time, because I was starting on my makeup journey, is another It brush that is an angled brush. This is called the Angled Heavenly Luxe brush, I believe. And it is used a lot for cream blushes, because when you buy this, the only place that I've been able to find it is on HSN, and it used to be on QVC, but now it's on HSN, and it comes with a cream blush. So I figure that because you get the easy pay, you get the cream blush and the brush that is never going to wear out on you. I'm not kidding. I have tortured this brush, but it just picks up the perfect amount of blush. And then I'll just pat it into my hand just a little bit and then really lightly start. And it just seems to deposit blush like no other blush brush I've ever had before. Say that 10 times. It's really a beautiful brush. I have talked about this over and over again on my channel. If you are able to afford it, this is one of those brushes that is so special. And I have washed this. It's stained. I have a backup of it now. I bought another one in case I ever lose it. I'm going to go into a panic. I need to do the same thing with this one. I need to buy a backup for it, but I haven't taken the plunge on that. But oh my word, these two brushes right here are really worth the money. So you have a particular brush that you can't live without or that you've had for years and just outperforms and does so well. I'd love to hear from you in the comment section below. I always love your input and I love finding great products that are affordable too, but if they're worth the money, I'm okay with spending that as well. So I really do hope that you are all happy and healthy. Please stay safe out there. I love you all so very much. Take care of yourselves. Next video, I'll see you. Bye.